Spider-Man 3. Oh my god. There are not words to explain how much I hate this movie. This movie is really bad, I think. And the reason is because the storylines were rushed. There was too many, you know what I mean? And another thing was the villains were not developed enough. Some villains, others were developed pretty good, and other villains just became really soft or died really fast, and I thought that was pretty stupid. Let me explain the villains because I feel like that's the best way to tell this story and how what this movie's about if you've never seen it, if you're one of the billion who have not seen this movie. So now, this is how the villains are. There is one known as Sandman, and Sandman becomes Sandman because he escapes jail and he goes into like this pit and there's sand in there and that's it. He just becomes Sandman. I don't really know how that worked out, but whatever. He's the coolest villain in this movie. He is the most developed because you'd think the second villain, known as the Green Goblin's son, Harry Osborn, who tries to carry on his father's legacy by wearing the same kind of stuff as him, would be more developed because he's been in Spider-Man, the first one. But he's not as developed, and I find that kind of funny. Also, what I thought was the worst developed, the least developed, should have been the most developed, Venom. Venom was not developed enough in this movie, and that really gets me angry because Venom was my favorite villain, my second favorite villain in Spider-Man. My first was Carnage, and people say, Carnage and Venom, what's the difference? Well, Carnage's difference is this. The guy that becomes Carnage is already crazy. He escapes like an insane asylum, and when a guy gets a symbiote, and Carnage is stronger than Venom too, I think. So that's pretty cool. So a guy who's already crazy with the suit that makes him even stronger. You can just imagine the damage. But Venom's pretty cool as the thing is that Venom is bigger than Carnage in the cartoons and comic books. So enough about that. This movie is pretty much Peter Parker is trying to get with Mary Jane. But he finds out also that the guy that's Sandman was the real guy that killed his uncle and not the guy that he attacked in the first place in the first Spider-Man. That was just an accomplice. He wasn't the real guy. But yeah, so he is pissed and he wants to get revenge against Sandman. Now, the symbiote goes into Spider-Man's suit, making it black and making him more of an asshole and also more vengeful. He wants to kill Sandman because of what he did to his uncle. So he makes him vengeful and arrogant, and it just makes him a douchebag, you know? But there is a scene in this movie where I think it's pretty stupid. It's just Peter Parker walking around, pointing at girls and stuff, and this was to make him seem cool, but I thought it was the lamest thing I've ever seen. It was so bad that I used the word lame to describe it. Watching that scene, you're like, did that really just happen? When I was in the movie theater, I was like, really? I mean, it's funny, but it just doesn't belong in the movie. It has no place. So Harry Osborn is pissed because his father was supposedly killed by Peter Parker, and I hate how this movie portrays it. Portrays it like Green Goblin was killed by himself, and Peter Parker had nothing to do with it. Spider-Man had nothing to do with it. He did have something to do with it. He had some responsibility in that death. I don't care what Spider-Man tries to, justify himself, even though we all know he killed himself, supposedly. But I mean, if Spider-Man wasn't there, it wouldn't have happened. So, yeah, I could see why James Franco is pissed, wanting to kill Spider-Man, but it's just like I like how it starts off. He's about to attack Spider-Man, but then he gets hit in the head and he forgets. And he thinks that Peter Parker is his friend again, but he starts remembering stuff, and yeah, he wants to kill him again. Eddie Brock, who is Venom, you know, they got Topher Grace for this movie, and I thought that was the worst casting decision. It was really bad because Topher Grace, first of all, is like, he's a funny guy. He's not a strong guy, so that's what we want for Venom. We want a guy who's strong and who can destroy Spider-Man because that's what he does. And as soon as the black suit goes from Spider-Man to Venom, the symbiote just, it doesn't look as cool as it did when it was actually on Spider-Man and not on Venom. And also, I felt that, like, Eddie Brock was not that cool in this movie, you know? He's just a reporter that got fired because he was taking fake pictures of Spider-Man that never happened. He was trying to show that Spider-Man is a villain when Spider-Man is the great hero for this city, you know? So, yeah, that was pretty dumb, I thought. But I mean, they just messed up Venom. Like, he had like 20 or 30 minutes of screen time, and I thought that was dumb, and he wasn't developed when he should have been there since the first Spider-Man, in my opinion, because he, to me, he is the villain that lasts the longest as Spider-Man. He's not like a small-time villain. He's been in Spider-Man for probably the longest out of all the villains, and he's the one that gets the least screen time and dies the fastest. Here's a spoiler alert. If you have not seen this movie, please close this. I don't want to spoil this, but I just want to give my opinion about the ending because it's so bad and I want to hear everybody's comments about this, okay? So, if you've not seen this, please close this. Please do not watch this if you're one of the billions of the people who have not. So, now that you have closed this, and I'm pretty sure you could come back and write, you know, whatever you think after you've seen the movie, but close it, come back, tell me what you think. Okay. The ending was stupid to me because Sandman turned good. I thought that was stupid. He's like, oh, I did this, it was a mistake, blah, blah, blah. What do you think about that? Tell me. I thought that was dumb. Even though I'm not gonna say Sandman was ridiculously bad, I thought Sandman was the best part of this movie. And then Green Goblin dies by his own thing, his own hoverboard. Why do they always die by that? Why do they create stuff like that if they're gonna die by it, you know? And another thing that pissed me off was Venom. When the Green Goblin threw the grenade into the symbiote and he was retracted from it, so it was just like Eddie Brock looking at it, why would you jump in there? Huh? Why? I understand you can't live without being Venom, but you know, you could have. Maybe there's more symbiote. You don't know. Why would you jump back in there? And just, why would they kill Eddie Brock that fast? That was kind of dumb. So for me, the rating of this movie is a 5 out of 10. Half decent. It's not decent. Just half, okay? It's not. What I mean by half is it's half good, half bad. The good is it is entertaining at times, but not like for Spider-Man fans. For Spider-Man fans, this movie was painful, honestly, because it doesn't follow Spider-Man in any way and makes up stuff, and it has too many storylines, so much is going on. Mary Jane and Peter Parker, and then there's Gwen Stacy was barely in this movie. Like, they used her to get back at Mary Jane, and that's not how it is. And Venom was barely in it, and there was the Venom and, you know, the Eddie Brock and Peter Parker scenario, and then there was the Green Goblin, and then there was the Sandman and his daughter and his wife, and it was just so much shit going on at once. You can't concentrate on it. So, and it was 2 hours and 20 minutes. It was a lot of time, but even with that much time, they couldn't concentrate on all that. So that's why it gets a 5 out of 10. But I would still rather watch this over Iron Man 2 because it did have some good parts in this movie. But most of it was bad. I mean, if it wasn't bad, I'm gonna ask Lex Luthor. Lex Luthor, this movie wasn't that bad, right?
Wrong!
Okay, goddamn, Lex Luthor, you don't have to go all wrong on me like that, son. I was just asking a question. Shit. But that's how much Lex Luthor hated this movie. Anyway, tell me what you want me to review next. Please stay away from horror films because I want to do those for Halloween. When Halloween comes around, you hit me with those horror films. But ask me any other series. Try to stay away from Batman also because it's hard for me to do Batman right now since The Dark Knight Rises. I want Dark Knight Rises to be finished and then do it maybe, or you know, maybe when it's the day before Dark Knight Rises or something like that. But anyway, any other superhero franchise I'll do, and stay away from horror films, and just recommend the movie in the comments below. Subscribe.